Hey everybody, this is Queen Lyric, artist and founder at Queen's Beauty Bar. And this is going to be our first tutorial. Now, I'm going to say this. I'm very goofy, so like you're going to have times in the video where you see me like dancing or singing. Just discard it. It's just kind of like what I do. So, before we go into the actual techniques and everything of this look here, this is my natural look. I'm gonna just go ahead and let you guys know, I don't believe in just using MAC products or just using Sephora products. I use products from everywhere. And it's always good to try to get other products and, you know, test them out to see the quality, because you never know, like, what brand or what certain item works, you know, for you. You could go to the 99 cents, well, not the 99 cents store, but you go to Walmart and shop, you know, Black Radiance, the Queen Collection, CoverGirl, and you might find a product that is actually good for you, you know, or is better on your skin than a MAC product. Totally encourage it. As long as you like it, use it. So we're gonna go ahead and get right into it. I'm gonna show you guys a list of all the products first, and then I'm going to go ahead and go into it. So I hope you guys enjoy, and subscribe. Make sure you subscribe, because we don't have any subscribers. So make sure you guys subscribe. Like us on Instagram at @Queens_beautybar. Follow me on Instagram at @LyricFranchelle. We have a Twitter, but I don't like Twitter, so right now the Twitter is not popping, but you know, who knows? All right, hope you guys enjoy. Bye.
Okay, queens, let's get right into it. So right now I am just moisturizing with MAC's Prep and Prime in Yellow Radiant. I'm also taking some Cocoa Butter Lip Balm. And after that, I'm just putting on my eyebrows, my regular routine for my eyebrows. Now that I have added some fill-ins in my eyebrows, I'm just taking some concealer and some highlight, Peach Luster, from MAC, and I'm just highlighting my eyebrows. You just want to follow the natural line of your brows. A little product, not too much, and you just want to spread it all around. Now I am taking MAC's concealer brush and I'm just blending out the rough lines. When you're doing your highlighting, you just want to make sure that everything is all blended in so that you get a nice flawless look. You don't want to have lines. Make sure your eyebrows stay in place as well. Right now I'm just taking my beauty blender and just making sure that everything is all blended in. And I'm going to add a primer on my lid. I'm using MAC's Paint Pot and a concealer brush. And I'm just going to go ahead and blend that all into my lid. Now I am taking Urban Decay's Naked 3 palette in the color Limit. And I'm just going to go ahead and apply that to the lowest part of my lid. Now I'm taking a blending brush from Morphe and I'm just blending out all of the lines. I'm also going to add this glitter color Buzz to my lid to just give it a little bit more of a pop. Cause I'm willing and I'm able. Categorize me, I defy every label. And while you're selling dope, we Now I'm taking Max Warm palette, and I'm just going to take a color that's pretty close to my skin tone. We're going to use this as our transition between our highlight and our shadow. I'm just taking a blending brush and just sweeping it over. A little bit of product, not too much. I just want to create a little dimension. Oh my gosh, I just got so excited because the sun was finally coming out so you all can see the makeup a little better. Now I'm just taking a different brush. This is more of a precise brush, and I'm just adding a little bit more product to the outer part of my eye just to give it a little bit more dimension as well. Just creating an illusion. Now I'm taking a dark brown and just kind of outlining where I want the darkest color to be, the darkest shade, and it just creates a little bit of a smoky eye, but not too dramatic. And I'm just using a little bit of product and I'm pulling it closer towards the my nose so that it can have like a very like an ombre kind of look. Eyeliner. It's very important to know that eyeliner is probably going to be the thing that takes the most time because you have to be very precise. Usually what I do is that I outline my line with a liquid liner. This is by Stila. And then I go over it with a gel liner, NARS, Black Valley. And this also just helps the liner stay, but you want to take your time with this. I usually do very dramatic eyeliner, but you can do whatever eyeliner you like. Now that my eyeliner is done, I'm just going to go ahead and do something that is called balance. And basically all that means is that you're going to take the same eyeshadow that's on your lid and you're going to put it on the bottom, like in your tear duct area, just so that it opens up your eyes a little bit more. So I'm just taking that color Limit, and I'm going to take the transition color and a little bit of the dark brown just to give a more of a dramatic, balanced look. Now I'm just taking a dark liner and putting it on my bottom lash line. And I use Maybelline, and as you guys see, like I warmed it up so that it'll go on a little bit easier. But you can use any pencil that is good for you. And that wraps up my eyes. The Black Panther Party. And none of that okay sugar, as long as you play the background getting my beer and rubbing my feet, bullshit either. You dig? No, this is time for put your mind on your soul. Right now, all I'm doing is prepping for my highlight, and I will have a video where I just do highlighting and contouring. I'll do it after I complete this video. So once this video gets 100 views, then I will do that video. And if you guys want to see any specific techniques, just go ahead and drop a comment in my comment box, and I will try to make a video about it, okay? Guys, just let me know. Boardroom, so give me more room. Deny my opportunity, you in jeopardy. Yo,
set me free. Don't hinder me, let me be.
I'm fighting for freedom. I got the heat in case you need them. A straight soldier. Ain't nobody told ya. Hold up on them lies. I know your games and your plans. Do whatever you can to oppress.
Now I'm just adding my concealer. I usually don't do it in this line, but for some reason today, I guess I wanted to do it that way. So here it is. Once you start adding your concealer, you just want to make sure that you keep all of your shadow on that bottom line, that bottom lash line, just so that you don't lose that. Just make sure you go in and add some shadow if it gets lost in the process of highlighting. Right now, I am taking my favorite foundation from NARS. This is the Weightless Foundation in the color Trinidad. And I'm just spraying my foundation brush with some Studio Fix. This just helps it spread and it kind of helps the foundation stay a little bit longer as well. So this is what I do when I put on my foundation. Right now, I am prepping my lashes with the Duo Black Glue, and this is the one I'm using. This I used to use a squeeze out, but this one has a stick, so it's pretty cool. I'm also contouring my face with Anastasia Beverly Hills's highlighting and contouring kit in medium to tan, and I'm just letting my eyelashes dry before I apply them. Right now I'm just highlighting again with the highlighting and contouring kit. I'm just putting a powder over that concealer so that it sets. We want to make sure that we're not too oily, but we are like dewy, but not oily. I just highlighted and contoured my nose. I have a very narrow nose, so sometimes highlighting and contouring just gives my face a more of a slimmer look. I don't do it often, like in my day-to-day makeup routine, but when I have like a natural look, it sometimes is cool to bring it out because it just gives my face a little bit of a more broad feature. It brings out my nose. I almost forgot about my lashes, you guys. I forgot that they were there. So now I'm just going to add some more glue. And I'm going to go ahead and just stick them on. And it should be fine. It shouldn't be a problem. Don't forget your lashes.
Truffle did it, me at the queen in the park.
call me cute and sexy like that. And me plant the corn, so no better watch that. Cho, S me no spade, me no king, me no jack. Me a the queen and me run the pack. Shuffle up the deck and me come pan top. Say uno no se patcha and no dead stock. Anything test them off, it kick back. Rally back, me rally back and me not.
Now I'm taking my translucent powder from MAC and I'm just going to put it in the areas that I highlighted to really set it and kind of, you know, make sure that it doesn't get oily throughout the day. You can put it over your entire face. Some people set it for their foundation. I just put it on my highlight just because I don't have very oily skin.
No call me a be play. Man, I rush my body just like a hot bread. And over on a body, no man not dead. The queen they are no so spread the red carpet. A long time will not try a time no food.
Lipstick. This is my favorite lipstick combination. I am taking Chestnut from MAC and I am lining the outsides of my lips. And I am taking Kinda Sexy by MAC. It's like a pink nude. And I'm just gonna go ahead and put a little bit on, and that is my nude lip.
And I rush my body just like a hot bread. I never own nobody, no man not dead. The queen they are no so spread the red carpet. A long time on
the right now I am blending out my translucent powder and just adding a little bit more to my contour because I kind of lost it a little bit. And you are supposed to contour your forehead as well, but I don't because my hair usually covers my forehead. Now I'm just going to go ahead and highlight with Urban Decay's Illuminated. And I'm just going to put that on the highest points of my cheekbones and on my nose, my cupid's bow, and my chin. Okay, sometimes I go ahead and add Striptease by NARS in the center of my lip just to give it a little bit more of a pop. And to finish my look, I'm just going to go ahead and splash my Studio Fix and voila, there it is.
All right, you guys, so this is the finished look. Very clean, very just subtle. All right, thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate all of the love, the support. Remember to like, share, subscribe, and love yourself. And remember that no matter how beautiful you are on the outside, if you're not beautiful in the inside, then it doesn't matter. All right, see you guys next time. Bye.